take a look outside. This place looks rather ominous as we arrived. Behind the wall, now anything could happen. So we can't exit this way, only that way. This doesn't look very cheerful at all. I wonder why we've stopped here. Probably because Hans Vorarlberg was here.
Kate Walker! Kate Walker!
Oscar, what's going on? Why has the train stopped? Where are we?
The springs of the train are unwound again, Kate Walker. As for the question pertaining to our geographical location, I really haven't the slightest idea.
Well, we'd better get looking for a winding machine, my dear Oscar. I hope that this place actually has one.
The air here is so polluted that I could not possibly risk leaving the locomotive. My joints might corrode irreparably.
Right. Let's see.
Of course, he couldn't possibly leave the train here. I'll have to go find a train winding machine.
Gosh, it's really gloomy here. I wonder where on earth I'm going to find a winding machine.
I have total confidence in you, Kate Walker. You are, after all, a brave and resourceful woman.
Yeah, right. Let's hope Hans Vorarlberg once lived here as well. Maybe he planned for his locomotive's unplanned stop and installed a winding machine as well. Otherwise, it's not looking great for the rest of the journey.
Do not forget that Hans Vorarlberg is a genius in the true sense of the word.
But is he a genius with a sense of forward planning?
We will find that out when we find the winding machine.
My God, Oscar, what would I do without you?
He's got such faith in his creator. I think I'll go look for the machine now. There's nothing in particular I need to talk to Oscar about. No, I can talk about myself.
Okay, let's try looking on the bright side here. I need to stretch my legs.
Is there something wrong, Kate Walker? Are you uncomfortable? Are the passenger facilities on this train substandard? I shall draw up a formal complaint form for you immediately.
No, Oscar, everything's fine, I assure you. A little walk will do me good, that's all.
Very thoughtful. I could ask him for help, but he already said he doesn't want to leave the train. So that probably won't do much.
Oscar, you couldn't make a little effort for just this once. If we both went looking for the winding machine, the two of us together might find it quicker.
You are in all probability correct, Kate Walker. But the high level of heavy metal miasma that pollutes the atmosphere could cause havoc to my wheel work.
True.
We just keep stopping. When will we ever get to the end of this journey?
Simply wind up the spring, and we can set off immediately.
From your mouth to God's ears. See you soon, Oscar.
I shall stay right here, Kate Walker.
Right, it should be along the platform. It's an interesting place. Looks like an old mining facility. What's this? Another voice cylinder that we can listen to in our train. And looks to be the plans of this huge statue. Interesting. And the sort of handle or lever. Right, so that looks like the Vorarlberg.
If that's going to work, it looks like something's missing.
Voilà, There we go. Very imposing. Can we go forward more? That was easy enough. I guess we have to go back in order to leave, because there's no ladder going all the way down. That's it. Let's run back to our train. Oh.
Hey, you there.
That doesn't look very good, does it? At least the train is wound up, so we can leave whenever we need to. Oscar's not here anymore. Let's go check inside the train, because that's where the man was coming from. Wonder what he was doing there.
My God, Oscar! Oscar, talk to me!
That will be difficult. Poor Oscar.
Are you okay?
Why, it is absolutely inadmissible, intolerable, and indescribable. I have been attacked.
What do you mean you've been attacked?
My hands. I no longer have them. They have been stolen.
My God, you haven't got your hands. But who did this? What's going on here?
We can be sure of one thing, Kate Walker, that this heinous crime was committed by a barbarian, a dysfunctional individual whose behavior lacks all finesse.
Did you get a look at your attacker? Tell me exactly how it happened.
I was standing here polishing up my metalwork. I was just thinking that with all the dust in the air, it would be a good idea to...
Oscar!
I was very busy, and I suddenly felt two powerful arms grab me from behind and tie me up before I had the chance to defend myself. I wanted to call out, but my attacker gagged me before I could emit the slightest sound. Then he dismantled my hands with a terrifying pair of pliers. It was horrible!
I can believe it, my poor Oscar, but did you see him?
He was a real barbarian, I tell you. He had bloodshot eyes, steel teeth, and brown scaly skin, and he emitted foul odors. He was a monster, Kate Walker, a real monster, and he had a weapon.
Oscar, please calm down. Everything's going to be all right.
We hope. I'll need to get his hands back, I guess, before we can set off.
Right, Oscar. Let's go find this hand bandit. And this time, we're not going to be such a pushover.
Kate Walker, Please do not think that this problem does not concern me. But if it's all the same to you, I would so much prefer to stay here, just to be on the safe side. An engineer never abandons his train, after all.
Yeah, sure. Another good reason not to lend a... I mean, not to help me out.
Kate Walker, even an automaton deserves a little compassion. I have just been savagely assaulted. Oh, I can feel one of my spasms coming on. I am on the verge of a clockwork breakdown. And all you do is accuse me of being selfish.
Okay, take a rest, Oscar. You're not much use without your hands anyway.
Indeed, he isn't. I'll just go find his hands.
Right, I'm done. Take care of yourself, Oscar.
Good luck, Kate Walker. And don't forget me.
Of course not. You're the whole reason we haven't set off yet. Can take these. There's a little hand appears here, but I don't think you can actually do anything.
No
with
point
it.
Weighing myself down.
Yeah. I think I'll listen to the voice cylinder before we set off. Maybe it has some clues as what Hans was doing here, or if he was here. We can assume so, considering that construction we saw outside. And the fact that he left a winding machine here, that he did spend some time here. So maybe the voice cylinder has some information on that.
My dear brother, what joy to have news of you after your long silence during the war years. So you're working for the Russians now. I tell you, we've been hearing some worrying stories about them here. Just your description of that dingy factory makes me cough. But it's so good to hear that your talent is being recognized for its true value, and that your automaton creations are taking the place of workers for all those menial jobs. I'm so proud that Vorarlberg automatons are making such a contribution, even if it is small, to the improvement of people's lives.
Meanwhile, back in Vladilen, we've been licking our wounds after the war years. Some people have returned, others not. Life is slowly coming back, but it's taking time. All my love, Anna.
Right. So he worked for the Russians after the war. Oh, good. And there should be some automatons here. This used to be a mining facility for the Russians. Communists, I assume. Let's go find out what happened to Oscar's hands, because obviously without his hands we can't leave. I think the man left the other way though. We could go check if there's another. If you can follow him straight away. I don't think there is. Let's check it out.
That door is locked.
Of course.
I've got to find another way around.
So let's try that lift we found. Back. And back.
Hello? Hello?
Kate, it's Dan. Can you hear me?
Dan, is that you? I can't hear you so good. Dan?
Hey, can't talk. This is the last conversation. Are you still mad at me? Come on, it's important.
Dan, you're breaking up. I'll try and call you when I get out of this mine.
You... Kate! Come on, what's happening? Listen, we've got to talk.
Look, the line's just getting worse and worse. I'm hanging up.